the energy vibration reading for the fourth quarter of the year 2018. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. Thank you for the wonderful positive energies that you guys have been sending. Thank you so much. This is going to be general energies for the last quarter of the year. Yes, we are finally at the last quarter of the year. As we go to the last quarter of the year, we're going to be looking at what is going to be happening. This is just so beautiful. The last quarter of the year is going to be something of some significance change that is going to be coming in for a lot of people, okay? Some really significant change that is going to be coming in for a lot of people. And I'm so happy that the last quarter of the year, you have the energy of a hurt energy that is balancing and grounding out. Because remember, this is the general reading, okay? All right, as usual, these readings are going to be a little bit longer, so you can pick up the rest of the reading from on demand. Okay, alrighty. Let's look. It's a beautiful, beautiful last quarter, because this is the reading for the month of October, November, and December. This is a beautiful last quarter that is going to be happening. I'm seeing a lot of energies in December coming up, like really powerful energies that is going to be coming up in December. As we said, the energy vibration of the heart is changing. And as the energy of the vibration of the heart change, then you will see all these situations and all things that you weren't aware of coming up out of the blues and that sort of a thing. But it's going to be good. Now, general energy is the energy of a heart. It is the energy of the air event. So a lot of people are going to be dealing with organization. And this is a time when people start to change their jobs and that sort of a thing. That's the time when people start changing their jobs. This is what happened as people start changing their jobs in this time. Okay, I'm sorry for my thing on this, but I got it. So once again, thank you to each and every person, and to all the winners, if you're watching this, to all the wonderful winners who have basically win the first on demand. I'll be still giving away stuff, so this is going to be good for you guys. So okay, this quarter is a beautiful quarter, as I was going to say. The first month of October, which I'd expected that the energy of October would be a water energy, okay, and the energy of November is going to be a hair energy, which is good. And the energy December is going to be emotional, okay, but it has the energy of the lovers, okay, so this is good. So the general energies for this quarter is really going to be fabulous, in the sense, because the hermit is just making you be aware of information that you wasn't aware of. And the organization, there is things, if you have a business, this is going to be good for you guys in the month of December. If you have a business, you know, in the month of December, it's as if it's going to be taken off. And it's that this quarter is going to affect a lot of the Taurus people. A lot of the Taurus people who are in business, this is going to be taken off very well. Not only the Taurus, but the Virgos and the Capricorn, okay? And that's in the month of November. Things are going to be getting up and moving forward for you. So this is going to be good. So let's look and see what exactly was transpiring. And the month of October, we have the energy of the hermit. Now, the energy of the hermit is a positive energy. Just as the month of October is always a month when you're breathing and you're taking down. Happy birthdays to all the Librans and Sagittarius in the month of October, okay? So this is going to be good because it's inner wisdom and guidance, a wonderful situation that is happening. Things are going to be transpiring in your life. This is going to be changing. Information is going to be coming to you. Also, help is going to be coming to you, but we're going to be looking deeper. November is going to be a beautiful, beautiful month, and the energy of the star is always wonderful. I'm always saying to people, make your wishes and dream in November, because this is the time that is really going to be coming out, because this is just wonderful and powerful in the month of November, because whatever you hope and dream for in November is going to always come in December. Okay, so this is good. I'm seeing that my grays are also out with you at this full this reading. So okay, in the month of December is a fabulous month. It's the energy of the Lovers. I'm seeing a lot of weddings are going to be taking place. A lot of people are going to be moving. A lot of people are going to be visiting family and that sort of a situation. And this is going to be very, very much wonderful and very much positive in the sense that we are understanding where we are and the things that is about to happen. Okay, so this is a good, okay, whatever the situation is, you're going to be seeing this. This is going to be happening, and this is going to be extremely, extremely good. So let's look and see what is the transformation that is coming out. So in the month of October, going in the month of November, let's look and see what is the transition. The transition is that you have the energy of the Empress coming in. Now, the energy of the Empress is wonderful. It's another major arcana, which is good. And this is helping you to balance out your materialistic endeavors and your financial endeavors. Okay. So this is all about you trying to bring a balance so that in December, you both, your family and yourself will be both aligned with the right energies. So as we look in November going into December, we have the Knight of Pentacles coming in. Now, the Knight of Pentacles is a message that whatever you were wishing and hoping for in your financial world or your materialistic world for the month of December to connect with your family, this is going to be happening because the money is actually coming to you and it's not going out. It looks as if it's going out because I set it down. But if you look at the side, you will realize that it is not going out. It's basically coming in for you. Okay, let's see basically what is going to be the outcomes of this fourth quarter of the year, which is positive. You have the energy of the Sun. So as I said to each and every person, this positive energy is just so positive because the last quarter of this year is so very positive. It's coming in a very, very positive situation. And what you're going to be realizing is that in the month of November for the Aries people and the Leo people, this is going to affect you guys where not only the Aries, Leo, and Aries, Leo, and Capricorn people. This is going to affect you guys because whatever you're working on, whatever you're doing, is just going to be very fabulous. If you have your own business and that sort of a thing, it's just going to be very, very wonderful because what you'll be realizing is that doors of opportunities are not only going to be opening for you because wonderful situation is going to be happening in your life. And this is basically just so positive because of the energies that are here. Things are just so positive, just wonderful, positive experience that is happening, okay? So as we look at a certain situation in our life, we're about and we're understanding a situation that has transpired and we're working to bring this imbalance, and this is going to be in a very, very positive way, okay? It's really going to be in a very positive way. So whatever that has transpired, whatever in your life that is about to change, is going to be in a positive. So again, in the month of November, you know, the Capricorns, the Leos, and the Aries people, it's going to be just fabulous, really, really just fabulous. There is just so many things that is going to be changing. So I'm loving this because it's you know, for the Aries and the Capricorn, it's just going to be good. It's the Aries, the Capricorn, and the men, the Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn, men between the ages, or women between the ages of 25 and 30. It's just going to be wonderful. Okay, so as I'm looking at these energies, I'm seeing just a wonderful positive situation that is about to come out. Whatever the situation that you have with an organization or with your business, whatever organization, corporation, or that sort of a thing, November will bring you positive messages for the Capricorn and the Aries people, the Leos also, but the effect is going to affect the Capricorns, the Taurus, and the Virgos, especially for the young people between the ages of 25 and 40. Now, October, for the Capricorn, is as if your wishes and dreams are going to be coming out for the Capricorns in October. It's as if something that you have always wished, hoped for, and dreamed for is going to be coming out in October. Now, the Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn men between the age of 25 and 40, some of you are going to be connecting with the love of your life in the month of December. And this is going to be wonderful. And this is going to be extremely wonderful and extremely positive, because you are going to be realizing that you are connected with the right person. And this person is going to be supporting you and helping you throughout your time. You're going to be connected with this person. Some of you could be getting married in the month of December that is coming up, and this is going to be good. Okay, so wonderful. Whatever is happening for you guys, you need to understand that, you know, positivity is what is going to be taking place for you guys. Positivity is the name of the game, and that is what is going to be taking place for you guys. And with this positive energy that is going to come out, you are going to be realizing how beautiful it is, because you are going to be transforming your life in such wonderful positive energies that you yourself is going to be really, really out looking forward to see what is going to be transpiring. And this is going to be extremely good. Okay, so thank you for being here. If you would like to see the extended reading, please, if you'd like to see the extended reading, please go to the on-demand website. Okay, so thank you again, and namaste until next time. Welcome this to the On Demand. Okay, let's see what is happening. So let's check in to see what is going to be happening with these energies that is happening in October, moving on into November. We're going to take a deeper look. So welcome to all the people who are on demand. This is the fourth quarter reading, and we're going to go further, but we're going to take a much deeper look in the situation. So the energy of the Hermit is here going in October, going into November. And there's a lot of talking. There's a lot of talking. This could be talking about whatever that is transpiring. This could be your angels and guides coming in and letting you know exactly what has transpired, what has happened, and that sort of a thing. So there is going to be a lot of talking, and especially if you're doing business, there is going to be a lot of connection that is coming in business for you guys. Okay, let's see what is coming in the month of November. There is going to be wonderful positive energies, especially for the ladies. It doesn't really matter what age you are. There is just going to be wonderful positive energies that is coming out for you ladies. There's a lot of talking about over you guys. There's, you know, people just like to gossip. I don't know why people gossip so much, but yeah, people just like to gossip. Okay, let's see what is basically coming out. What is going to be the outcomes, because I'm seeing a lot of talking, and let's see the outcomes about a new start, and a lot of talking about a new start. Okay, this can be a lot of talking about a new start for some of you women, because you could be changing jobs, you could be deciding to go work for yourself, you could be deciding to deal with other situations and other people and that sort of a thing. And this is going to be wonderful because I'm seeing you're looking within and you're seeing certain aspect of yourself in certain situation, especially the ladies over 40 that is in business or is about to do business, especially in the month of November going into December. You ladies are going to be really, really balancing out things. I'm seeing a brand new start coming up for a lot of you. If some of you were sick, I'm seeing the ending to the sickness and a positive energy that is going to come in and aligned. So this is good. Sometimes people just like to gossip because they see other people trying to make something of themselves and moving forward in their life, and people just love to gossip. It's just a normal thing that people just basically gossip. I don't know the reason why. I don't have the time for it, but there is always the situation that people always gossip. Now we are going to be looking to see what other energies are coming out, and this is we are going to do all the 3 months to see what other energies that are going to be coming out. I'm using the Good Bad Tarot deck. I love this deck. I think it's one of the most beautiful, beautiful decks. So let's see what else is coming out. So in the month of October, you're going to have the energy of a transition in the month of October. Now transition with the energy of the hermit is a good positive energy, because what this is saying is that this is moving you. It's as if you're learning to understand certain things, certain aspects, and this is moving you to a positive place in your life, where you, the energy of the hermit, you're seeing all these transition that is happening around you. There's a lot of people, there's a lot of conversation that is going on, a lot of you, especially who are making changes in your life. You're going to be seeing all of this coming in, and it's just going to be coming in a very positive way, okay? Because this is it's as if you have aligned yourself with more positive, uplifting people in your life. Ten of Wands comes in, and I love this energy of the Ten of Wands, because whatever the situation is, there is a transition that is going to be coming in the month of November, and it's as if whatever you were wishing and dreaming and open for, this is going to be aligned in with your hopes and dream, and the burdens are going to be basically, and you know, it's not really burdens, but it's just situations that you need to move yourself out of, and there's going to be a transition for that. Okay, there is really, really going to be a transition for that. Then as we look at this energy, we have the Five of Swords. There is going to be some conflicts. Whatever the conflicts is, and whoever the conflicts is going to be with, you are going to be understanding certain aspect of situations and people, and this is just going to be so wonderful, because you're just going to be removing yourself from certain energies and certain people. You're just going to be understanding that there are certain situations that you really, really need to, and it's as if your angels and guides are going to be coming in and said, listen, this is unhealthy for you, whoever you are out there. It's as if you're just going to, with the energy in October, you're just going to decide that the situation is just not for you anymore, and it's just so unhealthy. And the burdens that comes with it, you're going to decide, no, this is it. I don't really want to have that sort of a situation in my life. And this is going to be good, because there is this quarter is basically a transition, an ending of burdens and conflicts that are going to be coming in. Okay, it's just a form of ending of burdens and conflicts that are going to be coming in. And this is really really good, because we're coming to the end of the year, and we're basically trying to have positive energies moving forward. Okay. I like to do these energies because the other deck is the Chakras Wisdom Oracle. I'm doing the Chakras Wisdom Oracle. This is a very, very positive deck. I like to use this deck because this is very, very positive in a sense. So let's see what is coming in October. Despondency. So With the transformation in October, we have the Hermit and we have despondency and we have transformation. It's as if you have come to a realization that, you know, you're just going to be moving forward, whether in physical or mentally. You're going to be letting go because this is the energy of the purple, which is an healing. So despondency is when we decided that we have seen that whatever that is transpiring is just not what you want to be in. So you're going to be using the form of despondency to just elevate yourself and move yourself forward to something much better. November, another purple. So fate, have faith. Have faith in whatsoever is happening. Just have faith. Have faith in things that is about to transpire. Just have faith. Whatever the situation is, have faith, because with faith, you will release all these burdens. I'm seeing that it's a portal for healing that is coming in. Prayer. Prayer. Just pray. Whatever the situation is, especially in December is a positive month to pray because it brings in new energy in the new year. So whatever it is, you know, there is a lemonade and I love lemonade so much. Just pray about whatever the situation is and whoever you have to deal with, because there is a miracle, a miraculous situation that is going to be working out. There is really a miraculous situation that is going to be working out. Okay, so just pray, and you guys have miracle comes out, and whatever the conflicts is, because this is going to be, it could be with a relationship in the month of December, that some of you have some conflicts within a relationship in December, and you're going to be praying about this. Just pray, do not get involved with the negative surface of worrying about situation. Just pray about the situation, whatever that is coming in. Just pray about it, because as you pray about it, what is going to be happening is that you are going to be changing the energy vibration of whatever is happening. Some of you are going to have a strong foundation, whatever is happening. You are basically going to have a strong foundation, whatever the situation is. You are basically just going to be having a strong foundation in your life moving forward, and this is going to be good. We're going to be looking at love, and as we look at love in this quarter, we are going to be disseminating what is going to be transpiring for love in the month of October. We have the Seven of Pentacles. Now this in love is that some of you are going to be focusing more on building something in your life to bring out positive energy. It's as if you want to bring more positive energy in your life. You're building on something in your life which you want to bring out in a very, very positive way. So most people are going to be with despondency, making transition in their relationship, especially in the month of October, because it's all about you seeing the truth and the light about situations and relationships around you, and you're going to be using despondency to make a transition and work on this in your life in the month of October. As we move into the month of November, we have the Four of Pentacles, and it is here twice. Whatever is happening, the energy of the Four of Pentacles is here twice. It is a wonderful energy, because what is transpiring is that in the month of November, your stability is going to be good. And in the month of November, your burdens is going to be over, and you're going to be using faith to hold on and send this out in the universe, you know, that this situation is too burdensome and you want to end the situation. And this is going to be positive, because you see the Four of Pentacles is here. With the energy of the Four of Pentacles, we are aligning and we're showing certain aspect and certain situation, and we are working together to align ourselves with certain situations in your life. Let's see what is going to be happening for December. Nine of Pentacles. So this is what I was saying to a lot of people, that in the month of December, it's as if for the Capricorns, you know, things are going to be happening for you in December for the Capricorns there, and especially the ladies over the Capricorn ladies over the age of 40. A lot of stuff is going to be happening for you and Aries. Okay, it's as if you are in business, this is going to be good things is going to be happening. Whatever quarrel is it, and whatever hate that is coming at you, whether in your work or you decided to leave and a lot of people are, you know, like against you and that sort of a thing, not to worry about it, because this is going to be working out in a positive way. Okay, and this is what I was saying, especially that business, work, and that situations for a lot of you guys, because for a lot of you guys is going to be transition, it's going to be you finding your part. It's as if some of you are ending the year and deciding, this is not doing it for me, I'm going to be making some changes in my life. But in love, a lot of you are going to be more focused on you know, making a transition in your relationship in the month of October. And in November, you're trying to build a stability in your life with the love of your life, whoever this person is. And then in December, there is going to be money coming in for a lot of people in December, because December is always a month where there's a lot of gift, there's a lot of situation that is transpiring, a lot of wonderful situation that comes up, and this is going to be very, very positive. Okay, this is going to be extremely positive. And be aware of envy for you Aries and you Capricorn people. Envy, the energy of for the people, the energy for the people, and we are looking at the Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorns between the age of 25 and 40 in the month of November going into December. A lot of wonderful things are going to be happening, because what I'm seeing is that some of you are going to be seeing the truth of a situation, and you're going to decide that no, I don't want this to happen, this is not going to be happening. The energy of the sun is going to come out. It is a quartile that is finishing the year with the energy of the sun, which means that positive new energies are going to be aligning the life, your lives. And this is going to be, there is going to be a really good focus on you guys moving forward in a very, very positive way. A really, really positive way that you guys are going to be moving forward in a very, very positive way. And I'm basically loving this for you guys, because what is going to be happening and what is going to be transpiring is that you are going to be realizing how beautiful the quartile and this year is ending. You're ending the year with the energy of miracle. And this is very good, because this is your solar plex. So ask for a miracle in the month of November, because that is the month of to make all your wishes and dreams come true. So ask for a miracle in the month of this November, because this is going to be your wishes and dreams are going to be granted. Okay, so for all the people in the month of November that is going to be carrying burdens, you know, ask for a miracle. In December, there is going to be some conflicts and that sort of a thing. Ask for a miracle for the resolution of these conflicts and situation that is going to be happening. Okay, my guides are guiding me to do something else, and they want me to align these dependency and the Seven of Pentacles. Dependency and the Seven of Pentacles is that in a month of October, a lot of people are going to be working on either their health or their financial stability. So I'm seeing that most of you, especially in the month of October, because September is going to be, and you can see the energy already in September, you're going to be working on your health and your financial stability into this world. And this is going to be taking you to a wonderful place, because with faith, you're going to be able enough and consciously enough to heal your relationship, whatever is going on in your relationship and in your health. You're going to be able to really heal that situation. I'm loving the energy of this quartile. It's really beautiful. An invitation is going to be coming to you, and this invitation is going to be very, very good. With faith and prayers, some of you who are deciding to move away and to change your jobs and that sort of a thing. It's really, really going to be happening for you, because what you're going to be seeing is that you're going to be seeing wonderful positive energies coming out, and this with the holding faith, having faith that something is going to happen, a situation is going to be resolved, praying and having faith and asking for the best outcome and the good of all things. You're going to be seeing that this situation is going to be transparent and going to be happening. Okay, so it's basically a beautiful quarter, I should say. I never expected this quarter to be such positive energies coming up in this quarter, but it's going to be very, very good. Not to worry if I didn't say anything about your zodiac energy. What I should say is that for the water people, the Pisces, Cancer, and Scorpio, what is going to be happening is that finally you are going to be aligned with positive situation and positive energies and that sort of a thing, and you're going to be very successful and have a new start. So if you water sign was looking for work in the month of September, that is going to be coming in October. In November, for the air sign people, the Gemini, Aquarian, Gemini, and Libra, this is going to be a very, very positive time for you guys, because what is going to be happening is that you are receiving all the energies of these months, and you're going to be receiving extra financial stability in your life, and you're going to be working towards that. People are going to be coming in to help you, and the energy of the sun, a new start, a new birth is coming in for you ladies, okay? The men also. So for you Aquarians, Gemini, and Libra, it's going to bring a new start, especially if you're about to change jobs to another organization and that sort of a thing. In this last quarter, it's going to be in a positive way. As we look at the energy of the Gemini and the Cancers in the month of December, it's going to be positive. Some of you could be getting married in the month of December. I'm seeing some of you connecting with the Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. So it could be the Cancers who are connecting with the Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. I'm seeing the Geminis and the Aquarians could be, connecting together in a relationship, and this is going to be extremely wonderful and extremely positive. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to wish you a wonderful, miraculous, and I'm wishing each and every person who is over here on Vimeo that a miracle will come for you, and I'm asking the angels and guides to align you guys so that you will receive a miracle in your life. I want to say namaste until next time.